Hello and welcome to this travelogue edition of C++ Weekly. Now, if you're not interested in this kind of thing, feel free to skip this video. I just like to, from time to time, do a travelogue about the kinds of things that I have seen and done in my travels with C++. In February of 2024, my C++ training took me and my family to Vancouver, British Columbia. Now, this was our first trip to Vancouver. And I found it interesting myself to note how different the East Coast and the West Coast feel culturally. Now, really, this shouldn't be surprising. Canada is, after all, a big country, but I just had never really explored around, so it was an interesting aside for me. So here's a travel tip for those of you who are traveling for work between the US and Canada. Yes, they have international tax treaties like 100 plus other nations have with the US, but you have to pre-file for a tax withholding waiver with Canada if this applies to you. The process can be a bit annoying and time-consuming and probably involves sending faxes. Yes, faxes. So make sure you have at least 2 months ahead of time before you actually need to work in Canada so that you can get this squared away. Well, when we arrived in Vancouver, we had the threat of rain, but otherwise lovely weather and we had plenty of time to kill, so we took the train slash subway from the airport to the Broadway City Hall Metro stop and used a Bounce luggage storage place. Bounce was easy to use after installing the app and the train was easy to use, assuming you have Tap and Pay on your device. This is Google Pay or Apple Pay kind of scenario. And there is a local transit card, but they also just straight up accept the credit card. So we opted to use the credit cards. And this process worked great and not great when it didn't. First, don't try to check in multiple family members with the same device. You'll get an error saying that you've already checked in. So this could be a problem if you're traveling with your family. And second, while the train worked great, we only had about a 25% success rate with buses, and it was a bit embarrassing to keep trying to tap over and over again. Now, we both have Google Pixel devices, although different models, and I don't know what was going on. It would just get read error after read error, and then it would work, and there's a line of people behind you, and it's really annoying. From the luggage drop, we walked to Granville Island. Yes, Toys R Us does still exist in Canada, and no, I did not go into it. Granville Island is a sort of industrial space that's been updated to be pedestrian friendly with many little shops and marketplaces, including this surprisingly amazing little broom store that we just had to walk through. Now, I wasn't in the market for a handmade broom, and I have no idea what it would look like to carry that back through security with me, so I did not buy one today. In the Granville area, you can find a lot of local artisans, bakeries, and various foodstuffs. We loaded up on some provisions for the week and then started our trip back to our luggage drop-off. The walk back was amazing with some great views of downtown. This was really fortunate for me that I got to see these views of downtown because I really wouldn't see the sun for the rest of the trip here. And on the way back, we stopped at a Whole Foods and got the rest of the food that we would need for the week. Now, if you watched our previous trip report, you know that we deal with some food sensitivities and allergy problems in my family. And so staying at an Airbnb, doing our own grocery shopping, this is a normal part of travel for us. The Airbnb that we're staying in and my work were unfortunately relatively far east of downtown. So we took the most dangerously driving Uber that we've ever been in and got settled into our Airbnb. I worked for the next 2 days while my family explored the city as much as they could. It was on one of these outings that my family learned about the problems with scanning with Google Pay on the bus. Now, the train system is great if you're going somewhere along the few main lines. Otherwise, there are many buses available. Although downtown, about a third of the buses that they saw were listed as not in service, and several times over the next few days, our journey was disrupted with a bus suddenly going out of service. My family spent about an hour taking public transport out to Stanley Island for a nice walk on one of the sunny days that they had. They did not spend any time in the aquarium or museums because they just couldn't pass up the fact that there was some sunshine today. The totem poles were worth the visit, although pretty crowded and hard to get pictures without a bunch of your local tourist friends in the pictures with you. The bus is delayed by 15 minutes when they are ready to leave the island, negating any time saved over walking. So they just walked all the way back to Gastown. The steam clock was fun to watch, and also predictably surrounded by many other tourists. Before heading home, they wandered into Choices Market, a big, nice grocery store with lots of natural, organic, allergy-friendly options, although it was a bit expensive. The next day promised to be bad weather, so they planned to visit the Metropolis Mall at Metrotown. This mall is huge and can easily fill an afternoon and has convenient free lockers available. They were struck by the obvious influence of a century of immigration from Asia, given the huge Asian grocery and other smaller Asian stores where there were no signs in English. Now, I had one day left to tour Vancouver after my work was done. Sticking on brand to our other travel log, we decided to take the bus across town, about an hour, to the Vancouver City Museum. After about another 45 attempts to scan my phone on the bus, we arrived. The local city museums are always interesting, and this one did not disappoint at all. Despite a school group arriving right when we did, we had the place pretty much to ourselves for most of our touring. The local perspective is always great, and it was enlightening to see the history of Vancouver told from the First Nations perspective. If you're not familiar with this term, First Nations is the term used largely in Canada to identify Indigenous peoples. It is disappointing to see how much of Western and European history involves the oppression and marginalization of minority groups, but it's also refreshing to see how many museums now acknowledge this. I'm sure that this is not unique to just Europe and North America, but it's where I have personally seen more museums directly or indirectly recognizing this part of their past. The weather was really not great today, but we managed to use the afternoon to walk around the Kitsilano area to a Starbucks, a couple of amazing little local chocolate places, a fantastic nut roaster store, and then Uber back to our Airbnb again. We spent the rest of this evening inside because the weather just wasn't great. Now, the next morning, we needed to mail a customary postcard back to my wife's grandma. We learned in this area that there are full post offices, often hidden in the back of other stores, like drugstores. So if you're looking for a post office in Canada, go look there, at least in the Vancouver area. Now, this is its own unique thing that I have not yet discussed in our travel logs, and that is sending mail in another country is always an adventure. Usually the hard part is finding the post office and navigating the actual customer service line. You want to make sure your mail is addressed just as you normally would in your country, and then put the name of the country that it's going to at the bottom. And I'll have a pop-up here that shows that. Then you hand the thing to the postal worker. It doesn't matter if you speak any of their language at all. They'll show you a number that you have to pay. You pay that amount of money. And then they put a stamp on it and they mail it. We've done this in many different countries now. So after another 50 attempts to get my phone to scan on the bus, we arrived at the mall. We killed some time and then took the safest Uber driver I have ever had on our way back to the airport and had an uneventful flight back home.